Best is yet to come. Best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. I'll wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till our lips have met, and wait till you see that sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? Best is yet to come, come the day you're mine. I'm gonna teach you to fly. We've only tasted the wine. We're gonna drain the cup dry. Wait till your charms are ripe for these arms to surround. You think you've flown before, but baby, you ain't left the ground.
She's the person that knows me the best. She's the person I always want to go to tell a funny story. Or if I have to cry, she's the shoulder that I want to go to. She, as an older sister, she's the one who I aspire to be like. Many such qualities. Sorry. One such quality that I aspire to achieve is how in tune she is with her intuition. When I first met Jordan, they had already known each other for a month, and Michelle told me that he was the one for her. And so when I first met him, I was really protective and reserved, but that's just me. And I'm just so happy that they met each other in San Diego, and I was living in San Diego too at the same time. And I got to see their first year of their relationship. I saw them grow together, and I couldn't have asked for a better brother-in-law. He's, not only is he cool because he's traveled everywhere, he's witty, he's super attentive, he's really thoughtful. He can make anyone feel special. And in the first year of their relationship, I saw my sister's soul light up with this new passion in life. Not just the love for each other, but this new, like, hunger to fulfill her own dreams.
Jordan Hollenbeck is a maverick. To my knowledge, he's one of the first men in the world to begin getting both back and Brazilian waxes. I once saw Jordan eat a bowl of cereal with a fork. Real maverick. But seriously, Jordan's a great friend. And I think as many friends here can attest to that. He is kind, sometimes thoughtful, perpetually hilarious. I had a dance joke in here, but he did such a good job of cutting that. I thought it unfair to use just my opinion, so I decided to ask Greg Frederick, Jordan's good friend, what he thought, and if he had any stories about Jordan. And he shared this. My friendship with Jordan started with him knocking on my door at 2 a.m., holding his pillow and blanket, and asking if I would like to have a roommate. I used to think this was unique and meaningful, but as I've gotten to know him better over the years, I realized that this is likely how many of his friendships began. And possibly how he started dating Michelle. Thanks, Greg. That's great. Please join me in raising a glass to Michelle and Jordan.
Today, it has been nothing but tears of joy. To see the happiness and the radiance that emanate from that couple has just been overwhelming, and couldn't have made me happier to know that Michelle is with such a wonderful person from such a wonderful family. And what's amazing is that they started as a sailing lesson for a charitable cause that led to the beginning of a lifetime partnership. And Jordan, I want to tell you, you are welcome into our family with wide open arms. I couldn't be happier. So with that, I would ask you to raise a glass. I have a simple toast. Michelle and Jordan, we wish you love, happiness, a long and blessed marriage. And as a grandfather, might I say, a fruitful one. Salud.
I know a little hideaway up by a lake, and you're the one and only girl I love to take. Can you dig it? All I really want to do is stay.
We love you guys.
Congratulations.
Together, alone at last, like in that dream we both had in the past. Can't you see us just sitting round the fireplace, sitting such an easy pace, watching while the snow falls down. Dig it. And in my hideaway, I'm gonna get to know you. It's such a fine time to show you how sweet I can be. No, baby, we won't tell a living soul where we are. We're gonna cuddle up and fight the cold. Just count stars, can you dig it? How's about on Friday night? We catch a plane, then on Sunday afternoon, come back by train, can't you dig it?